Hello and welcome to another episode from the Water's Edge. Today you catch up with us at Cobblacre Lakes on the Front Lake, and we're actually halfway through one of the first challenge matches here at From the Water's Edge. This challenge actually came about as me and Chris were actually fishing this very lake 2 or 3 weeks ago, and we were astonished by the amount of roach that are actually swimming around and topping as soon as you put any bait in. Chris asked me on the little walk around, what weight do you think you can do in a match? And when I replied 50 pounds, you see his eyes light up and the famous words, I bet you can. So this is what we're here today to prove. We've got 5 of our hard-earned pounds on this match. I think I can do 50 pounds. And Chris, by the looks of him behind that camera, is getting a little bit worried too. I think I've already had about 30 pounds. We've got 2 hours to go. The deadline is 8:30. I'm a bit eager to get fishing. We'll see if we can catch a few more fish and we'll talk to you a bit more detail as we go along. Let's get back out there. So I really have got the swim going quite well now. As I said, we are 3 hours in, so the competition's been going, the bait's been going in for a long while. I've been doing a few calculations in my head about how many fish you need to catch. I mean, £50 doesn't particularly sound that much, but £50 is 800 ounces. And from what I've been catching, I would roughly say the fish are averaging 2 ounces. So as a rough guide, I'm going to need to catch 400 fish in the 5 hour period, which is not far off a fish every 40 seconds. And in that, if you include, you've got a bait up, hook a fish, net a fish, land a fish, whatever it may be, creating any dry spells, any tangles, anything like that, it is quite a lot, and you have consistently got to do it for 5 hours. You can't sit there and not have a fish for 5 minutes, because then you find yourself needing to catch a fish every 10 seconds or so, which really isn't that easy to keep going at that pace. All I'm doing is just trying to keep these maggots going in. They are boiling on the surface. Chris is looking slightly more paler and paler as this match goes on. Really want to nail this last bit. Today's challenge, I gave myself 2 options. I've set up 2 completely different rigs. First of all, is the one, if you follow some of our videos, I've actually fished it before, which was a whip with a long piece of line, and then you fish it about 1 foot deep and you're swinging everything to hand. It is really quick on its day, and that's what I honestly thought I'd be catching on, but I started on that for about 15-20 minutes, and all I managed to do was miss a lot of bites. I probably hit 1 bite in 10, and it is quite windy. It just didn't feel like the presentation was right at all. So this brought me on to the second rig that I'm fishing now, which is basically a short pole with a short piece of line. What that's helped me do is it helped me hit a lot more of the bites. I'm probably hitting every other bite now I'm connecting to a fish. We're out of the water here now, so I'll quickly show you the rig. Basically, it's nice and simple. This is the short line that I was describing to you. Between the pole float and your elastic, it's nice and short. Just helps you hit them bites, and when it is windy, you can keep it more controlled. That's on to a 0.2 Garbolino float. I use these for all my up in the water fishings. They're nice and short and nice and sensitive. The rig's 0.12 and the hook is size 20. Apart from that, with this speed fishing, it is pretty much more about your baiting technique. The way I always like to describe it, if you can imagine you've got a big room full of children and a box of quality treats, if you were to chuck the whole box in one go, you'd have one massive fight, a big scramble to get as many as they could, but it would only probably last for about 10 or 15 minutes. If you do it this way, if you can imagine you chuck 1 or 2 of those in at a time, you could keep that competition going for a few hours. And this is the same, it's all about little and often, keeping them fish interested, make them come up in the water. one last thing you need to do to change while you're fishing this short pole is have the pole roller behind you, so you don't have to unchip. When you are trying to catch fish really quick, if you're going to be unchipping sections, taking your top kit off every time, you will not be able to do these big weights that you're after. This is what I mean there. My pole roller's on there, it's just a flick up, fish is in my hand. I've unchipped no sections at all. That is going to give you a lot more time fishing rather than unchipping. Slightly better fish on. You still don't need to unchip. Straight out. And that's how quick it is. Well, it's not too long to go now. Quick look at the phone. It says it's 8 o'clock, so we've got half an hour. Chris already believes that I've done it. I'm not so sure. It's quite hard when you're catching big numbers of these small fish to keep track of where you are. I'm sure I see him earlier doing a few star jumps behind the peg. Anything to sabotage and save himself a bit of money. In true fashion, he doesn't like losing as much as no one does, but I am determined to beat him. This last half hour could be crucial. Getting a lot of bites. I think there's actually so many fish there now, I'm starting to miss a few more than I was earlier. But they are still coming thick and fast. Get yourself in a nice rhythm, be comfortable, everything's to hand. You're not wasting any time looking for bait, anything is all as easy as you need to get there. I think as that sun slowly dipping, they may have slowed up a bit from earlier when we first started. Before the camera got there, we were really catching well. Nice fish though, these. I've certainly enjoyed it, whatever the outcome. Well, just had a tangle. We've got to put a new rig on. We've got 15 minutes to go on the home straight. Brought a smile to Chris's face, but couldn't have happened at a worse time. Just when you want to be putting that final finishing run in. Nice and quick though. Have everything pre-tied. And we're back out already. Be happy if I can put another 10 fish in the net. Well, Chris is standing there tapping his watch. According to my calculations, I've got another 20 seconds. Hopefully I've one more fish. It's on. And that will do. Challenge over. I think I may have just done him, but this is going to be interesting. Let's have a look what we've got. We've got Wayne's an independent adjudicator, because I know what Chris is like. He'll take any hands off me he can. I think it's going to be close. Let's have a look what we've done. They're all in, so let's give it the moment of truth. I'll lift Wayne Call
12 pounds.
I'm 55.4, I'll give you.
55.4. We got there in the end. That was a struggle, only just. But that's probably the best fiver I've earned in a long while. Let's get these fish back. Well, that's challenge number one to me. I think in the future we plan a few more of these events, give Chris a chance to win his money back. Quickly like to say, if there's anything you'd like us to do a challenge match on, or another video, please feel free to contact us, either via YouTube, Facebook or Twitter. We have got some of these competitions lined up. We're going to do a carp versus match video, and also a silvers versus carp. So there's some great videos coming up, keep your eye out for those. For now, it's time for us to head home. Thanks for watching the latest episode, and we'll see you on the next one.